The following program contains language, images, and/or subject matter that may be objectionable to some viewers. Viewer discretion is advised.
Direct from Albany, New York, it's time for The Media Zone! With your hosts, Ed and Dave! Tonight, a look at this week's new film and DVD releases! And the chance to win free movie tickets with the Poster Pairs game! And now your hosts, Ed and Dave!
Hello and welcome to the Media Zone. Ed and Dave here.
I'll give you one of these for old time's sake.
And Mike with you. We're all with you.
Dave saw this a couple weeks ago.
That'll teach me.
So here we are. Mike, we have not seen Mike, and I was looking for the...
I think you have, Ed.
Well, I have seen him, but yeah. On the set here, which this is the next to last, or penultimate, show we will be doing here on the set, the old set, we call it.
Mm. Yes. The penultimate Media Zone.
I reared a child, Ed.
That's what happened, right?
Unable to do anything anymore.
That's right. I found out it was 2009. We on YouTube, we actually have some of your last shows and Dave's first shows coming back.
As a temporary replacement.
Right. And then 10 years went by.
I'm still per diem.
Time flies. It seems like only yesterday. The reason I know that is because on my last day of work, because I'm now retired, Dave.
Ooh. Yes, you are. For now, till you'll go back. You'll be bored, but that's another story.
Usually I would have my headphones on, you know, and listen to usually Howard Stern at the beginning of the week, then music. And the last day I said, I'm gonna leave the headphones off and, you know, talk to people around me. That lasted a half hour.
What do you say? That decision was probably not a good one.
I put on our old shows on YouTube. I put Media Zone and Work in. And I got all our work horror stories shows. Mm. Boy, that's awful close. What is that? Oh, that's not the shot that's being seen. Yeah,
20 years ago, you could zoom right in.
Now it's high def. We don't want to.
Way back.
That's right. So I was watching our old shows. I'll talk about my last retirement speech later on. But Mike is here. We got to see what Mike's been up to for the past... 10 years, right?
Yeah,
almost.
10 years.
Nine, eight and a half.
Yeah, right around there. Mm-hmm. I had the child.
Oh. You had the child?
I had the child. That was it. That's it. The party's over.
And what prevented you from coming back? Were you scolded into not returning because you had to do your parenting?
Was this
your choice?
I'm the king of my castle.
Are you?
Yes.
I don't believe you.
Yes, no, I had to stay with the child.
Okay.
And, you know.
That's why Dave left his first time,
that is true,
right?
To be with the, to be with the children.
The Media Zone started in 95, and I was trying to think when you left.
Well, by then, my children were, one of them was already 4 years old, and the other one was in September of 95.
Oh, okay, so you must have been the two.
I think I left when my son went to kindergarten because he had friends that would come over and play, and God forbid the parents see the show and go, wait a minute, is that his father? You're not going over there to play with him.
Right.
So, so I stopped.
Yeah.
But for how long, though?
It was 2009 you came back. We actually have clips we'll show next time. One of Mike's last shows and your first show, which also happened to be one of the dreaded work story shows where you had quite the leak going.
Oh, was that the one show back?
That was your show back.
That was the tarps all over the place and the water and the new pig and all that kind of good stuff. Yeah.
Now, what's Mike doing for entertainment these days? Do you get out to the movies?
Oh, no, I haven't seen a movie. I've seen some children's movies.
Oh, yeah.
I did do a drive-in last year, which was nice. That was fun. One of the little the yellow people with the big arms. The Minions.
That would be the Minions. 10 years ago, right. It would have been something else on the show.
Right. Now it's the Minions. Yeah. I used to have little yellow people start. I used to swallow the yellow people and then spin on my head in here. You know, I was driving here. I was going, you know what? Maybe I'll, like, for old time's sake, I'll have a beer here. Because once in a while, I'd have a beverage.
You would.
And I think if I had a beer right now, I would die.
Were you a problem drinker?
Only for a couple of years.
Only for a couple of years.
And a couple of shows, which will never be aired.
So once so, heard, yeah. Some stories I can't tell until I'm retired.
Right. So, yeah, no, so it's too early anyway, plus not a big beer drinker at all, or in
no,
the morning?
No, no, beverage now and then, but nothing.
Not now.
Oh, no, nothing. No. Like, no.
Well, so, that's good to know.
Yeah.
So what do you do now? You have cable, people have cable, they don't have cable. What do you have for entertainment at home now?
I have no cable.
Mm-hmm.
I have the Amazon plug into the TV deal, and it's a Fire TV
mm-hmm.
that the child watches all his shows, and I wasn't home at night to watch TV anyway, so I never watched. It was no loss.
Mm-hmm.
I kind of feel like the odd man out here. I still work, and I have cable.
Well, I have cable.
I think I'm going to get away from cable, though. I think I'm going to go. I got that Roku.
Yeah.
And I really only have cable because I like, as you know, Ed, the hockey.
Right.
Mm. And I have to have that digital whatever HD crap to get the hockey package. But through Roku, Ed.
Mm-hmm.
Roku!
Yes.
Which kind of sounds like little yellow people. But
Mr. Roku.
The Roku.
We give you a nice TV.
Right. I could get.
Well, you want a hockey with a stick?
Oh. Chopstick.
Oh, Mr. Chopstick. Slide around on a light. What'd you have? Number six? Number six?
15 minutes.
But I can get the hockey with the Roku, Ed. And I can pay for just my team.
Okay. Oh, that's good.
So I might do that next year, get rid of the cable.
Yeah. What do we call that? The a la carte menu where you get what you want?
Yeah. Yeah. It's like going to the restaurant and ordering a steak and then $10 for a scoop of mashed potatoes. And three string bean, green beans for $5.
That's fine, man.
Did you actually get that somewhere?
Yeah.
You did? Where is that?
677 Prime.
Oh, okay. Mm.
You get your steak and then, you can get your mashed taters and veggies. All extra.
Didn't they close?
No.
I thought they were that big one down.
Downtown? Well, I hope they didn't close. Not that it matters to me. I go there once every 4 years. I can't afford that place.
No.
I got to save up for it for 3 years.
No, you're shopping for clothes in the toddler session now.
Oh, God, I'm leaving. We got that Black and Blue restaurant by Stuyvesant Plaza. That's a pricey gig, but that's good too. I've been there.
Black and Blue.
Hmm. It's
you're supposed to dress up or
steak?
Something?
Well,
highfalutin.
It's a classy joint, but it's people go in there where they don't care. Your money. It's all money.
Yeah.
But it's expensive. It's like a 677 Prime, but it's a steak and seafood.
Hmm.
Black and Blue.
Now, no.
Yeah, you know, when we started the show, there wasn't such a thing as political correctness.
Oh, you can't. Oh.
And over in our
production. That's why I can't do this anymore.
You can't do it.
I lose 10 of my voices.
Over in our production booth, there's a various ethnic sounds, which we can't play anymore.
No.
Once in a while, they come out.
Funny's funny.
That's right.
Funny.
That's right. Like, you can't. Everything anyone says offends somebody. It's time to just get offended and shut up.
Right.
Just deal with it.
Take it.
Call me a WAP. I don't care.
Yeah.
I don't care.
Do you have that over there in the production? Do you have the WAP tape?
Really?
Ed and I will pick up a bowl of fruit for you.
Say, where's the grapefruits?
See, but we can do that, right?
We can call ourselves. We can do that, right.
Right.
If it's yourself.
You think you can?
Even that
probably
is
not
professional.
No, because I think your group
Your
will
group.
Be will yeah. shame you. They will shame you.
My group's not awake now.
People are getting fat right. shamed and skinny shamed and all shamed. Hmm. Shame on you.
Right. It's the last show.
Penultimate. Right.
Next to last. Should we do any movies on the next to last show or not?
Oh, no. It's just.
No. We're not going to.
I can hear the five televisions turning off right now.
We're not.
I just did this and remind me of the Vern Troyer.
Oh yeah. Oh, Vern. Yes. Mm.
We did have. We do have deaths.
Was
I don't
that?
Know,
the,
but,
was that a self-inflicted?
They're
death.
Hinting at. Yeah. Yeah, yeah. They're mentioning that. You're right.
He had some depression and.
He hung himself with some dental floss.
No.
Yeah, you know, that reminds me of an ethnic joke.
A joke we can't do anymore.
I can't.
Well, blindfolding?
Sure. All right, so what are we doing? Are we doing anything?
We have two films. We dropped the first film.
Yes.
There's an Overboard remake.
Oh, no.
Should we take a look at that, producer? Do you have that? Do you have to skip over?
What is it? Oh, with the Goldie Hawn?
Yes.
I would rewind that 1,000 times to look at her buttocks.
Really?
I did. It was her, she had bare buttocks in that.
Did she?
She
it
did.
It was a thong, a bathing
a thong,
suit.
Not bare, but...
Yeah,
didn't she do like a scene in a movie where she was like a coach of a football team with her boobies in,
yes,
the,
in the bathtub?
In the bathtub, yeah.
Yeah,
okay.
I never saw any other part of the movie.
I would go for that before her...
The derriere?
You think?
Well, yeah. You're a breast guy.
I am.
She has...
yes.
She has some small breasts, but
that's
know,
okay. You don't want them. You don't want them oozing out through the fingers. All right, so we're overboard. What are we doing? Who's reading this?
You.
All right. In a splashy new twist, Ed, Anna Faris and Eva Longoria. See, Overboard focuses on Leonardo, a selfish, spoiled, rich playboy from Mexico, his richest family, and Kate, a working-class single mom of three, hired to clean Leonardo's luxury yacht. Oh, this is the opposite. They're doing the opposite of the original.
Yeah.
Oh, I can't read this because there's a staple. After unjustly firing Kate and refusing to pay her, Leonardo falls overboard. When partying too hard.
I'm not going back.
And wakes up on the Oregon coast with amnesia. Kate shows up at the hospital and to get payback convinces Leonardo he is her husband and puts him to work. For the first time in his life.
Yeah.
Oh, that's a little.
right.
But with Leonardo's billionaire family hot on their trail and the possibility of his memory returning at any moment, will their new family last? Or will Leonardo finally put the clues together and leave them for good? Rated PG-13 for suggestive material, partial nudity, and some language.
Partial nudity?
Partial nudity. Maybe.
Who's going to show the ass?
Maybe it's Leonardo.
Leonardo, the pruning shears are in the shed.
Oh, that looks funny.
I guess you have to change it up a little, but is this the way we want to go with it?
That's
horrible. Oh, it's a forehead. And a five head.
Who's that, a kid?
A young lady.
Speaking of foreheads, did you see the trailer for the new Jurassic World?
Yes.
Okay, just wondering.
Why, does it look good? Or?
Huh?
Something about a forehead?
No.
No?
No. How do you get four... How do you make the jump from forehead to Jurassic World?
I can
World?
Do whatever I want.
Okay, sure.
It's the penultimate show.
Are you going to go see that one? You
did see I don't know. I didn't really care for Jurassic World.
You said you liked it.
I like the big creatures. We're too much with these stupid little raptors.
The dinosaurs.
I want the larger. That's why I like that Rampage, which I didn't see yet.
The Jurassic World, very big in the Lego world, as that's my world now.
Is that your, yes, that yeah. would be your world.
Oh, they love the Jurassic Legos.
Mm. Are those the first film, or do they have new ones out for this new one?
It's a Lego adventure, I don't know.
Yes.
Did you go through the classic Disney library?
We touched on it quickly.
Like, quickly? Oh, okay. Yep. Like Beauty and the Beast and, Ariel?
We just watched the movie, the new movie out.
Oh.
With Hermione. Oh. Doesn't that sound dirty? I touched Hermione.
Yeah, I wouldn't touch Hermione.
That was very controversial at
LeFou.
With the LeFou.
Oh,
character.
Yeah.
If you blinked, you would miss it. And that's
you're a beast.
Is this show going to be on?
It is going to be
my
on.
My God, is he hairy.
We have, now this came out last week, but it needs to be mentioned. We're now starting the summer films in April now. It used to be the beginning of May. Well, it used to be May 25th a long time ago. But this came out last Friday. I'm sure it's still doing well, Dave.
I'm sure it is. Am I reading this?
Yeah, you read this
one. Oh, geez, nothing like telling me what I'm doing on this show. Avengers Infinity War, an unprecedented cinematic journey. 10 years in the making and spanning the entire Marvel Cinematic Universe. Marvel Studios' Avengers Infinity War brings to the screen the ultimate, deadliest showdown of all time. The Avengers and their superhero allies must be willing to sacrifice all in an attempt to defeat the powerful Thanos. Sounds like a thermos. Before his blitz of devastation and ruin puts an end to the universe. Rated PG-13 for intense sequences of sci-fi violence and action throughout language and some crude references. There you go. Yet another superhero film.
Now, do you think the Black Panther draw will just explode this thing?
I think it's got, well, Black Panther somehow, and it was a good movie, is now number 3 of all time on the list. So you had your, you know, superhero film people seeing it, plus the African-American audience who will go see that. So you add that together, I think this is going to be up near number 1. It has to be, right? You got all your characters.
Who's that guy? The big head.
Thanos.
Well, I don't know.
That's Brolin.
Josh Brolin?
Oh, Josh really? Brolin. He was the biggest Marvel villain. He's usually with the Fantastic Four, who have not made it into this... incarnation. Yeah, we just got Spider-Man to join in, and we paid off Sony, who owned the rights to that. And apparently we're going to lose a few heroes in this one.
What? Passing of heroes?
Some of the lesser ones, I would assume?
I think it's going to be the ones whose contracts are up, like Captain America.
Are they going to show them pass?
I think so.
Well, you can't do that, right?
I don't... Yeah, you shouldn't.
It's the films. They can all be resurrected in some manner later on. King Kong had a heart transplant, for God's sakes.
Okay, there you go.
Oh, that's exciting.
And we have the DVD releases. We still do that.
Are we doing that on the new one?
We will.
Or are we stripping down to next to nothing?
No, we're still looking at...
Oh, I remember this.
Yeah, I do remember that.
Now, there were 2 Jaws cartoons. Do you remember what the name of the other one was?
Jaws 2?
Jabberjaw.
Jabberjaw, right. I think that's the one I remember.
Yeah, I remember that one. I don't remember Mr. Jaw too much.
I just remember this weird character, this weird shark-looking character. Mr. Jaw.
I think Jabberjaw was the more popular one.
Well, I missed this one. Atomic Shark.
Atomic Shark. Yet another in the shark.
And speaking of Roku, by the way, there's some good old... 70s movies you can get free. It's called Mutant Sorority.
Okay.
And they have bad, you know, like the quasi-lesbian jailhouse.
Maybe a prison thing. Yeah.
Oh, boy.
Jailbait.
Oh, there's some entertainment there.
Right. Oh, yeah.
Or, you know, like Jailhouse Nurses Find Ecstasy. I was curious. I didn't know what it was about.
No.
Had no clue. So I had to watch it.
It's about the healthcare system.
Yes.
Right.
Had to watch it for an hour and a half.
Right.
These would you would
so
see.
So you were done.
Yeah. If that was the case, I'd watch it for 4 minutes.
Good film.
It drew me in. Oh, no. How many of these, Ed?
This is number 6.
How recent is this? It's got to be fairly...
Just out.
Oh, God. Out, just like a direct-to-video.
Yeah.
And what was it was a mole-type creature? The tremor?
It was kind of a worm-type thing. Yeah. I don't know what they are now, but Michael Gross sort of didn't give up on the series. He was in every one of them.
Yeah, well, didn't they do one that took place in the 19th century?
Yes. Might have been the 3rd one.
And he was in that one as well.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, don't give up a good franchise.
No, or Payday.
I remember that one.
Oh, yes.
Yeah.
40th anniversary.
Jeff Goldblum was in that?
Oh, yeah. And Donna Summer with the Oscar-winning song. Mm. What was it, Dave?
Thank God it's Friday.
That was a song in there, but that was Last Dance. That was the best part of the film.
God rest her soul.
Donna Summer.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Well, you
so
have
young.
You have been out of the loop.
I have been out of the loop, yeah. Oh, sorry. I had a donut.
The Royal Wedding Collection.
Now, I thought you would know about this, Dave. We can't see the... Oh, there it is.
Why
the
would
Hallmark
I?
Oh. Channel apparently had movies that this to-be princess was in. What's her name? Meryl Markle?
Oh, yeah. Meghan Markle?
Yeah, I cut
is this
off.
A Christmas movie?
I don't think
that... Then I don't know it, Ed!
You only know the Christmas
movie. I know the Hallmark Christmas films.
I guess she wasn't in a Christmas one.
Well, she may have been. Who knows? Hmm. They're very interchangeable. They use the same cast. They just throw them in different scenarios. And then we'll be coming soon to the Christmas in July Hallmark. So I'll be
a lot of Jenny McCarthy. She did a bunch of those, didn't she?
No, because... No. Jenny McCarthy? No.
She did some Christmas.
Jenny Garth, I think. Oh, she did do Christmas, but that wasn't Hallmark.
Yeah. Okay.
Hallmark. She said the Santa Baby and Santa Baby 2. Right. Yeah.
I couldn't name any of the Christmas movies, but I recognize them because they're all the same. And they're entertaining. And and I cry.
Oh, you know,
very sentimental.
You're delicate human.
I'm very sensitive. Sensitive Dave.
Are you getting the deaths together, producer?
Very sad.
This is Vern Troyer, Dave.
What? Oh, is it?
Look at that.
Vern Troyer.
I hardly recognize him.
His illness elongated his face.
I know, but somehow Stephen Bosco snuck into the Vern Troyer.
Quite a long face.
He could see Vern Troyer's glasses.
Nice to see you.
30 years doing the show, and it still can't get this right.
I was going to fix it, but I ran out of discs.
Oh,
Harry
Anderson. Oh. So useful.
Just found dead. Just found dead. And unresponsive.
Oh. Oh,
did he? That's how it's going to end for everybody.
He might.
He was unresponsive.
You know, you never know. It could be all an illusion.
Anybody remember that he was a fan of magic?
That's right.
Did he do anything other than Night Court?
He did a show called Dave's World for like four years. Geez. Then he retreated from Hollywood and opened a magic shop. And would do a lot of magic. And
then he was doing tricks in a tunnel trying to get back into Hollywood.
didn't pan out.
Sporting that 80s parted down the...
Okay, so...
Go ahead a little bit.
That's Jack Nicholson.
Yeah, well, he's...
Oh, there we go.
There we go. Susan's on spot.
Five easy pieces. Now, she was married to Mark Goddard, Major West, from Lost in Space. And her son's name was Goddard, but I was reading it, I think... She said the son was fathered by Jack Nicholson.
Oh.
And they just took the Goddard name.
Ooh,
and there's that...
a tangled web.
What's up? What was that?
I'm coming, boys.
Woody Allen movie. Played Against Sam, which you don't see anymore.
Yeah, you can't see on... I'm on the Amazon and Prime and the Netflix, and you can't get any of his movies free.
Not free?
No.
You gotta pay.
I love the Woody Allen. I don't know what he did.
Well, would you like us to recap for
No.
you?
Let's remember.
I love those movies, though. When I'm willing to overlook it, it's a trend.
Let's remember Woody as a sperm in everything you want to know about sex. That's how we want to remember.
Right.
All right.
there we go.
It's getting longer.
Stephen Bochco. I think he should be remembered for that fine Cop Rock. The dancing, like, judges and singing.
It was a musical cop show.
Yeah.
It didn't last as long as NYPD.
You think ever thought that was a good idea?
He went with the turtleneck. You go, it's too long. They can't see my neck, too. They'll think my head goes right into my navel.
I can't wear turtlenecks. It's like it's like a really weak guy who's, like, strangling you for hours. What the hell? What?
Deborah Carrington. You remember her as the little the little prostitute in the Total Recall thing.
Oh,
that's a shame.
With the little bosoms there popping out.
Is she the last one? Because are we bookending these with,
It wasn't planned that way, but that might be the way it's going to go here. Is there anybody else? Bookend with the little people.
Is that what we call them?
The little people.
It's little people now?
Wasn't that a Brian Keith show, The Little People?
It's not dwarf or midget.
No.
No, we don't do that.
Don't come on here and swear.
I don't know.
Right.
I'm so confused.
Dave, you do what you do best.
Oh, well. Yeah,
right. All right. He's going to tell the story again?
Cover my shot here.
Cover your shot.
He gets a close-up while I get up, so you don't see my
hand. It's the Poster Pairs game, folks, where the five viewers have written in. Oh, God.
Tripping over my...
Where you have written in via email, two numbers from 1 to 6. We select your entry, reveal what's behind the two numbers if they match you with 2 free movie passes, blah, blah, blah. It's to spin the wheel, but all that kind of crap. Okay.
Now, in the email a couple of weeks ago, I said...
I want to see him talk through that.
Shall we call his wife?
I said, we're not taking any more entries.
You did
a couple
that.
Weeks ago in the email. But we are going to keep these entries in because there should be a game segment on the new Media Zone.
The
which
new Media it. Zone.
You have Mike pull one out. Maybe he'll be lucky for the... Michael pull.
All right. Oh, I got a couple. Oh.
let's give away a lot of tickets on our penultimate show.
All right. Are we doing one on the ultimate show?
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, God. Yeah, go ahead. You need your glasses?
Yeah. It's Pamela.
Yeah.
Barbara Harder?
Barbara Harder. Barbara Harder.
What was the date on that? When did they bomb?
What number is there?
Barbara Harder. Barbara Harder. 2 and 3. 1942.
Oh my God.
1942.
I've been reading her name for years. I never thought of that.
2 and 3. That's
a good one.
I was a small boy going to school and I heard the airplanes.
Let's see. Here we go.
Come on.
Suggested last time for the final shows, we put all our project things up. Shockers, of course, which Michael was in the Scarecrow episode.
Mr. Natas.
Were you in the Psycho film? Yes, as the doctor. I have to get this put on DVD.
I will not sign a release.
Dave, what were you in that? You were the doctor.
I don't know what I was.
I know you and Michael had the scene together, wasn't it? It's her.
It's her.
Her. So, boy, look how fast the show just flies. No, we can't do that. We're not telling people to write in right now. Although, if you want to write in for more info, you can take a look at Kong there with the address
just
Media
Zone.
You
need to talk to someone. Because we don't talk to anybody anymore. We just write.
Right. The text.
That's right. Nobody talks anymore.
Oh. We will see you next time with the final show. This will be a little tug at the heartstrings, Dave and Mike.
I'm tugging at your heartstrings right here.
Is that what you're saying?
Oh, yeah. I got your heart right in my hand here.
It's just not what it looks like.
Sometimes you get a heart attack.
All right. We'll see you next time.
Longer? Well, we still have 30 seconds.
I forget. We just learned a couple of weeks ago that we go until it hits zero.
Right. Mm.
And then there's 30 seconds beyond that.
Well, the timer looks like you're ready. Your film is done.
Yeah.
Nobody under what age would know what this thing is we're looking at right now. That was the photo timer where you would develop your own black and white film.
Oh.
And film, kids. Film.
Film.
Give me that film.
All right. We'll see you next time.
The Media Zone has been a Cable 2000 production.